This is Swapnil Bhartiya, and today we have with us Thea from the Zephyr project. So tell us a bit about the project itself.
Zephyr project is a real-time operating system. We are great for where Linux is too big. Really small footprint, real-time operating system built with security and safety in mind, but for highly resource-constrained environments.
So what are the typical use cases of Zephyr?
We're seeing a lot of use cases in industrial IoT right now. A lot of folks that need devices that are very, very conservative on power use, have a lot of different options for connectivity, and really give the product developer the ability to pick and choose what features and functionality they want based on the size of the footprint that they're working within.
Why didn't you use the Linux kernel? What was the need to come up with the...
So we really wanted something specifically for instances where Linux was too big. So all the way down to the smallest embedded devices, the smallest sensors that are really going to, in a lot of cases, go out into the wild and just be charged via Wi-Fi or other smaller.
And Zephyr project has been for a while now.
Mm-hmm.
So what are the use cases that you're seeing in the market?
So there's a couple that I'm really excited about. One of them is called ProGlove. And it is a fantastic application. It's a glove that factory workers would wear. And it's got a barcode scanner on the glove itself. So instead of the factory worker or the person doing inventory in this major warehouse having to actually repetitively over and over scan with a barcode scanner, it's embedded on their hand. They can just, in the course of their natural movements, be able to do the inventory. We're also starting to see a lot of applications. There's one that I'm very excited about called IntelliJ, and they have shoes that they've embedded haptic feedback and a number of other sensors into the shoes themselves for manufacturing and really heavy industry where hearing from your supervisor or getting information could be difficult. They're able to communicate through haptic feedback in the shoe themselves. So we're starting to see a lot of really innovative products come out of Zephyr specifically because of the way that it's designed and some of the features that it has.
And as you see these, you know, use cases, what kind of community is being built around it?
So one of the things that we're the proudest of about Zephyr is the vendor neutrality and the community that's grown up around this, right? So no one company is dictating the strategic direction of the project. That's done through a collaborative governing board. And technical decisions are made in isolation of that governing board, obviously with influence, but the technical direction of the project is really based on the community and where the community is trying to take it, what the needs of all of the different member organizations, making sure that we satisfy those needs first.
You do talk about all the exciting use cases,
mm-hmm.
but there, I'm sure there are also challenges. What are those?
So right now, one of the biggest things that we're facing is just the number of boards and the number of community contributions that we're getting, making sure that we maintain a really good balance between having really good top quality code, but also having the flexibility to be able to quickly accept community contributions because we're getting, you know, almost a new board a day at this point. We're up to 110 boards, I believe, in under 2 years. So that's incredible growth, and so keeping pace from a project infrastructure standpoint, you know, Linux Foundation has been fantastic about providing those resources, but just making sure that the community dynamics that made us successful in the beginning and the right balance between being flexible and being stable is maintained as we scale up.
And as you also see these new use cases, are you also worried about losing focus of the Zephyr project?
So I think it would be foolish to not have that in the back of your mind as something that is a risk to any open source project, right? We can't be everything to everyone. And so one of the benefits we have about having the redundancy of voices within the room, right, and enough input from everybody in the ecosystem, we're able to really maintain that hyper-focus on being the best RTOS for resource-constrained environments. So again, we're not trying to be a little Linux. We're trying very hard to be the best of what Zephyr is, which is a very small footprint RTOS.